Well, Andy Potter is a teacher from Minnesota in the Midwest who's had the day off school because it's minus 40 degrees Celsius. Andy, thanks very much indeed for joining us. It's good to see you. Now, I cannot begin to imagine what minus 40 feels like, so you show me what it looks like.
Water guns here and a bucket of water, and we'll kind of show you the effects that water, what happens when hot water hits the cold air, but it's pretty brutal out there.
Okay, well, off you go. Here we go.
All right, let's do it. And I got my assistant here to help me out, my daughter Siri.
Ooh. Ooh.
Ready? Let's do it.
All right. Okay, so as soon as it goes out, the water hits the cold air, it turns to steam. Is it ice? It's actually ice.
Or it's
my
powdered snow.
Word. Okay, can you hear me, Andy? Andy, can you hear me? You can. Okay, so as soon as that water hits the ice here, it turns to ice? Is that what's happening?
I think it turns to vapor, basically.
It turns to vapor. Right, okay.
That's kind of a finale here for you.
You're going to show me what happens with a bucket of water as well. Go on, then.
Oh, yeah, here we go.
All right, go for it. Oh, my word. The thing is, I'm slightly concerned about you, Andy, because you look as if you've just got your gym jams on there and some old sweatshirt. Get in the warm. Get in the warm. Come on, get in. Get in. I'm getting worried. It is very, very cold out there. Is this anything that you've experienced before in your life?
No, nothing like this. I mean, I grew up in Oregon, and I've lived in Minnesota for about 11 years, and this is the coldest it's ever been since I've been here, and I think for a lot of people, this is as cold as it gets other than in Antarctica.
Yeah, I bet, and apparently it is all because the weather that you would normally have swirling around Antarctica at the moment, that is heading your way.
Yeah, lucky us.
So listen, how long are you going to be off school for then? What's the prognosis there?
Yeah, we were off yesterday and we're off today, and tomorrow morning it's supposed to be, I think, minus 25 Fahrenheit when we get up. So chances are we're Minnesotans. We'll probably just have a little bit of a delay, but no school closure. We can take it.
You can handle it. All right. Okay. Well, it's good to see that you're keeping your chin up anyway. Thanks very much indeed. Sure. And to your little assistant as well. Thank you for showing us just how horrible it is out there and how cold it is. Thanks, Andy.
Thanks for having me.